Today my guest is Pablo Semurbaycan. Welcome to our studio. Thank you. Your last novel, titled Gugark, became the bestseller of last month in Azerbaijan. How is the attitude of Azerbaijan readers to literature?
It was one of the bestsellers for last 2 months.
All of the 1,000 copies published were sold. Another 1,000 copies were published for sale. However, when you consider that journalists, doctors, teachers, students of literature faculties are the people that should read books, then you say then 10,000 copies are too little. The situation is better now, however, than it was 2-3 years ago. Maybe it's related with the content of the book, that books are not sold?
No.
Even in Soviet period, there were very dull books, but every genre has its reader audience. The circulation of books is going down in the whole world. It's also the case that in Soviet period there were no internet, social networks or forum. However, the circulation was still high. Several days ago I bought an old book from a shop. When you open the first page, a handwritten text says that the book is a present of a student to his teacher. Now I don't imagine that a student can present a book to his teacher saying that she is doing a very honorable work. We must accept that the degradation is covering all spheres. You spoke about the Soviet period. In Soviet period there was no political opposition. The people had no room to express alternative opinions, neither in press nor on TV. The people could not utter a word in even party assemblies. Now Azerbaijan sees an increasing interest in literature. Even the head of president's administration began to write a novel. How do you assess the return to counter-politics? Former President Rasul Guliyev also wrote a novel. Journalist Shahfalet Chobanoglu described these persons as those who keep silence while speaking. In Azerbaijan, there are such people that earlier were popular, had their audience, and later losing their reputation or changing their positions for a vote, lost their audience. But as they were popular earlier, they want to be again. Which is impossible now. Instead of bringing up the internal situation in Azerbaijan, they prefer to swear, to criticize Persians, Armenians. For example, Sabir Rustamkanlı, Rustam Behrudi, they cannot speak about internal affairs of Azerbaijan. I have not read Rasul Guliyev's novel, but I assume it is about love. It would be better if he described his political experiences of early 1990s. If he could do it sincerely, we would appreciate it and maybe pardon him. For instance, you mean he should have acted as Turgut Erdoğan? Yes, it would be better. There are enough people writing about love. But for instance, I couldn't have written about the period as that period as Guliyev. I was a child then, but Guliyev could do it. Rasul Guliyev's novel is not just about love. It compares the political systems, regimes in the world in a romantic style. There are systems that we can compare now. The Soviet regime, where mouthpiece literature campaigning for ruling regime and the literature with opposite ideas, and current regime. What's the situation now? There is a pro-regime literature now, but there is no opposite literature. There is no need for it, actually. As Sholokhov said, we had cut off personality in Soviet period. But we had personality at that time as well. Poems were devoted to Lenin. But look now, they write for Kemalettin Heydarov, Minister of Emergencies. Now there is no need for texts with hidden messages in modern Azerbaijan. There are persons that use an open language to criticize the regime, but there are some using hints. There is no need to hints. There are persons preserving their position, demonstrating solid civil position. As for writing, there are many prosecutors, for example, writing about values, degradation. Thank you for coming to our studio. Today my guest was publicist Seymour Baycan.